Yeah, well, it's a pretty exciting time right now. Connor's second album, his second solo album, Conquest, is dropping in 2 weeks. And then we go on the world tour. I've been Connor's manager since back with the Style Boys. It used to be the four of us riding around in a van. But with success, our family had to get a little bit bigger.
Sure, Connor surrounds himself with people who are agreeable. I wouldn't call them yes men.
Money! Oh! It went in! It went in! You a murderer, son!
Well, Connor currently has 32 people on his personal payroll. He has a personal assistant, a party coordinator, an ab trainer, basketball coach, an eyebrow specialist, sneaker jockey, two umbrella wranglers, a weed roller, a weed holder, a turtle sitter for Maximus, scarf caddy, a guy who punches him in the nuts so that he remembers where he came from, right. A perspective manipulator. Oh, that's a guy who's slightly shorter than Connor, who he pays to stand near him at events to make him look taller.
Yo, back in my high school days, I was in a band. You may have heard of them called Tony. We broke up over creative differences. Each Tony had an exclamation point after their name, and I thought my name should have a question mark. So it would be Tony. In hindsight, it was not my best decision, but that led me to Connor, so. Who's laughing now?
There you go, buddy.
Ow, dude, you bit me, Max.
This is my best friend, Maximus. My mom gave him to me when I was 9 years old, like right after my dad died. I feel like he's like the closest thing I've ever had to like a little brother or something. If I had like a mute brother that was hella scaly. As a hatchling, the doctor said that he had been diagnosed with soggy bone syndrome and that he was not gonna make it past like 6 months. But that was 20 years ago.
You're my best friend. Don't tell Owen.
Come on up here. This is Owen's world right here. This is where I keep all my gear. This is one of the earliest synths I ever got. The DX7, this is a classic. Oh, in Connor's show? No. In Connor's show, I just use this. It's an iPod, 60 gigs. So, you know, I can fit the entire show. And plus, like, a bunch of dope audio books.
It was year 3 at Hogwarts, and Harry was worried it would never get any easier.
Harry P.
Is it difficult to just be the DJ?
You know, a lot of people ask me that. They say, like, is it weird for you to be playing the background now? Because, you know, you used to be in Style Boys. And I always say, no, man, not at all. I mean, because I could never do what Connor does, you know?
Look, I'm a perfectionist. My first album sold 4 million copies, so this one has to sell more. And that's why I take this so seriously, you know? And I live for this music, and it can't go away. And that's why I personally wrote every song on this record. And I used over 100 producers for just 17 tracks to guarantee that they're all hits.
I made a lot of the beats on the first record, but on this one, Connor said he really wanted to branch out. It's good for him to grow, you know? And also, I played him a bunch of my beats, and he was like, no.
What's up, y'all? Got a hot new single coming, and it addresses some social issues that I think are being ignored. So keep your eyes peeled for that. We're gonna be surprised releasing it next Thursday at noon, and that's it.
Discrimination, it ain't right. I'm not gay, but if I was, I would want equal rights. I'm not gay, but if I were, I would marry who I like. It's not fair, I'm not gay, that the government has a say in who can love who not gay, or to which god you can pray on a gay. It gets me so angry on behalf of them. I feel passionate, not gay, so I pray for them and I say for them, we need to make a change, not gay. I see it clear as day, this area is not great titties. We need equality and for all to see that this is the new way. Not gay, it just seems not gay, wrong, not gay, that no one seems to care. Sports, we can't continue to pretend this not gay madness has to end. Not gay,
I was born this way,
straight,
you were born your way,
gay,
gay or straight, straight or gay, it's all okay.
Sure,
it's time to make a change.
Yes,
time to stop the hate. Who you are is beautiful.
Not gay,
not
lying
gay
in bed, next to 10 beautiful girls, all straight. And while I made love to every one of them, I was thinking about the world. Hot wings, true love trumps all predator. Flying kicks, not gay. Big watch, not gay. Missionary, one love. Gym socks, nunchuck, not gay. Light of fluid, HD, ninja world, peace, four wheel drive. Gay marriage, love, beef. Free love, golf club, two guys, not gay. Rainbow muff dive, Harvey Milk, Sean Penn, not gay. Drum solo, courtside seat, safe sex. One arm push ups, Leonard Skinnerd. I'm not gay. I'm not gay. I'm not gay. I'm not gay.
I was born this way.
I'm straight.
You were born your way.
You're gay.
Gay or straight, straight.
And now
gay,
it's time for sexual freedom for all. Sexual freedom for all. Sexual freedom for all. Sexual freedom for all. Not gay.
He's writing this song for gay marriage. You know, like it's not allowed. It's allowed now.
Usually I don't like to read reviews, but I'm just excited. Like I can't wait. I want to know how people feel about it, and I want to know how much they love it. So here we go.
What do you see?
Well, it's Pitchfork. They gave it a negative review.
They didn't like it?
No, like it's a -4 out of 10. +10, I assume. Pitchfork can be kind of pretentious, though, so... But, ooh, what? You ain't gonna knock my hustle. Let's look at another one. Let's pull it up. Rolling Stone. Okay. Out of 4 possible stars, Rolling Stone has given it the shit emoji. I can only assume it's a mess up, you know? They must have had a problem with their, No, this seems like the right score for how they're saying this. You know what? Let's just do a search. Conquest review. Oh, here we go. Here we go. Conquest, a triumph. That's a good one. Let me read this. This is on The Onion. So, you know, mixed. Let's call it mixed reviews.
So first you're in a group, you introduce us to the Style Boys and Donkey Roll, of course, we play the hell out of that. That's a hit for us, man. And then kind of you get that breakout moment. You get a phone call from Claudia Cantrell.
The one and only.
And she asks you for a verse, man, on her song, Turn Up the Beef.
Turn up the beef, throw your body on the flame.
But you take that moment and instead of just like kicking a regular verse, you know what I'm saying? You did something a little different.
The catchphrase verse, as it's now known.
Oh, yeah, yeah, hello.
I had been working on a catchphrase, mm-hmm. but what had happened was I just thought of so many dope ones that I was like, what if I put them all into the verse?
It's kind of bitch, say word. Dilbert. Doink to doink. Sorry, Dad. Dinky nuts. Squirrel jam.
Yeah, he said so many words I didn't know. That was a game-changing moment.
Usually like one catchphrase and a hit. He dropped like 30 on us in one night. Shit was crazy.
DJ Tanner.
Swanky Pups.
Moped music. Costco samples like a motherfucker.
Ooh.
Crank up the mids. Patrick Stewart Money.
You know who it is.
Connor for real.
Immediately I said, man, this guy right here, he's gonna make it big. Because when you have a catchphrase, the world is catched by your phrase.